Dear friends, the Hebrew title of the fourth book of the Bible is Bemidbar, means in the wilderness. It conveys to us the substance of the book, which is nothing but a brief account of the journey of the Israelites from Mount Sinai to the plains of Moab, including a period of about 38 years of wandering in the wilderness. The title Numbers was given to the book by the translator of the Hebrew original into Greek, somewhere the 3rd century BC. He must have been impressed by the sacred writer's great interest in numerical calculations. The book contains a good amount of statistics, figures, and all sorts of calculations. See chapters 1 to 4 and 26. Says Chaco Mullo. It is called the Book of Numbers also due to the fact that God ordered a counting of the people, a census of the 12 tribes of Israel. The Book of Numbers clearly demonstrates that God's covenantal relationship with the Israelites remained intact, even though they proved to be unfaithful. In the book, we get several instances of their sinful complaining and rebellion and the resultant sufferings. It was on account of that many of them perished on the way, and only those people who belonged to the new generation who chose to obey God were fortunate to enter the promised land. The Book of Numbers clearly demonstrates the importance of holiness, faithfulness, and trust in God and in His promises. Despite the Israelites' repeated unfaithfulness, God remains steadfast in His promises. What we find is a fulfillment of the promises which God made to Abraham, that his descendants would be His people and that they would occupy the land of Canaan. The book highlights also the abiding presence of God with the people of Israel in the form of the pillar of cloud by day and a flame by night. Even though all possible preparations were done for their smooth entry into the promised land, on account of their lack of trust in God, their actual entry was delayed very much. However, finally we find the Israelites ready to enter the land of Canaan. The Book of Numbers shows also the Israelites as a community on the march with Yahweh as their true leader. In the wilderness, which is the actual Hebrew title of the book, Yahweh, their guru, forms them and molds them into His people, His cherished possession. He uses His own divine pedagogy to teach them the right way and to foster complete trust in Him. The relationship between God and Israel is a master-disciple-guru-shishya relationship. The Israelites, however, often fail to respond faithfully to God. The book Numbers presents the perennial drama of God's commitment to humanity and the disloyalty of human beings to God, taken from NCB. Dear friends, faithfulness is one of the prominent themes of the Book of Numbers. Therefore, there are 10 Bible gems on faithfulness. 1. So realize that the Lord your God is indeed the true and faithful God. He is loyal to His covenant, and His love reaches to the 1000th generation of those who love Him and fulfill His commandments. But He punishes in their own persons those who hate Him, and He repays them without delay. So observe the commandments, the statutes, and the norms that today I command you to put into practice. Deuteronomy 7, 9 to 11. 2. He is the rock, and perfect are all His works, just are all His ways, a faithful God without injustice. How righteous and upright is He. Deuteronomy 32:4. 3. Now if you listen to me and keep my covenant, you shall be my own very possession among all the peoples. Exodus 19:5. 4. The master answered, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Since you have been faithful in little things, I will entrust much more to you. Come and share the joy of your master." Matthew 25:21. 5. And the Lord replied, "Imagine then the wise and faithful steward whom the master put in charge of his other servants to give them their allowance of food at the proper time. Fortunate is this servant if his master, on coming home, finds him doing his work. Truly I say to you, the master will put him in charge of all his property." Luke 12:42-44. 6. No trial has come to you that is not common to human beings. God is faithful and will not let you be tempted beyond your strength. He will give you, together with the temptation, the means to escape and resist. 1 Corinthians 10:13. 7. Let us hold fast to our hope without wavering. For he who made the promise is faithful. Hebrews 10:23. 8. So then, if you suffer according to God's will, entrust yourself to the faithful Creator and continue to do good. 1 Peter 4:19. 9. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, no harm would I fear, for you are there by my side. With your rod and your staff, you give me comfort. Psalm 23:4. 10. The faithful God will not fail you after calling you to this fellowship with His Son, Christ Jesus our Lord. 1 Corinthians 1:9. Dear friends, here is part of a reading taken from the treatise of Saint Ambrose on loyalty to God. Where a man's heart is, there will be his treasure also. For God is not wont to refuse a good gift to those who ask. So because God is good, and especially good to those who serve Him, we must cling to Him and be with Him with all our soul, with all our heart, with all our strength. This we must do if we are to be in His light and see His glory and enjoy the grace of heavenly joy. To this happiness, we must lift our minds. We must be in God and live in Him and cling to Him, for He is beyond all human thought and understanding, and He dwells in endless peace and tranquility. This peace passes all understanding, passes all perception. This is the good which permeates everything. All of us live in it, depend on it. It has nothing above itself but is divine. No one is good but God alone, because the good is divine and the divine is good. So the psalmist says, when you open your hands, all creatures are filled with the goodness. Through God's goodness, all the truly good things are given to us, and among them is no mixture of evil. Thanks.